Hi everyone, and welcome to this Crit Editorial Bite for Oxygen Not Included. As always, make sure to check out the Critters Tutorial Bite if you haven't already for an overview of the critter and ranching mechanics. This Critter Tutorial Bite is about hatches, which are one of the simplest critters to ranch, and a great place to start if you're new to ranching. Hatches are found in the temperate biome, which is the starting biome for many maps, including Terra. You can find them walking around, but also buried in natural tiles. Interestingly, the forest starting biome also spawns a single hatch, and always in the same place, so you can also ranch them for maps with a forest start too. Hatches have four morphs: the hatch, sage hatch, stone hatch, and smooth hatch. These are quite similar, especially these first three. They are typically ranched for their meat, for food, and their diet is the main difference between these three. But the smooth hatch is a little different, and can be used to refine metal ores into refined metals. Every hatch morph will live to 100 cycles old, and has a livable temperature range of minus 30 to 70 degrees Celsius, so within the safe dupe range. Let's start with the normal hatch, which has a wide range of edible materials, including sandstone, sedimentary rock, sand, dirt, and many dupe foods. I will say at this point that feeding any hatch morph dupe food is very inefficient and not advised. Also watch out for them getting near your food storage. Generally, sandstone and sedimentary rock are good choices, as you can find these in large amounts around the map, and as the goal is to breed them for meat, they simply need to be fed. Do note though that these rocks aren't easily renewable at a large scale, so making normal hatches truly sustainable is very difficult. Their diet will affect their egg chances, and eating sedimentary rock will increase their chance to lay stone hatch eggs, and eating dirt will increase the chance for sage hatch eggs. Hatches also convert half of their eaten mass into excreted coal. Although you can use this to power generators as a side benefit, there are easier ways to make renewable power. As a final note, hatches, and all the hatch morphs, are one of the few critters that will fight back when attacked by dupes, but they don't have a lot of HP, so aren't really a threat. Unlike the hatch, the green sage hatch converts 100% of its eaten mass into coal. However, they eat organic materials like algae, slime, and dirt. Generally, these are more difficult to make sustainably, but it is possible with dirt. Using pips and arbitrees, you would need 7 pips to make enough dirt for one sage hatch, meaning most of the meat would actually come from the pips. Otherwise, they are very similar to hatches. Stone hatches, on the other hand, eat rocks and metal ores, converting them into coal at 50%, like the hatch. As their diet includes igneous rock, which is sustainable from cooling magma, it is possible to ranch these sustainably. Bear in mind though, that an average volcano can only sustain a little under 5 stone hatches, and a minor volcano about 2. Plus, you'll also need some serious cooling to keep the temperature in the livable range. I did mention that stone hatches can also eat metal ores, and doing so increases their chances to lay smooth hatch eggs. This is the only reason you want to do this though, as they still excrete coal, which is very wasteful. Stone hatches also have a lot more health than the hatch and sage hatch, and can injure dupes if fought alone, so make sure to bring friends. Smooth hatches eat metal ores to excrete 75% of the mass as refined metals, which is their main purpose, instead of being ranched for meat like the other three morphs. This is better than the rock crusher, which has a conversion rate of 50%, but is less than the metal refinery at 100%. Doing this is a reasonable way to get refined metals, but usually unnecessary with metal volcanoes and a well set up metal refinery. Like stone hatches, they also have high HP, so should not be attacked by lone dupes. All hatches are easily moved, as they can simply be wrangled by dupes and brought to a critter drop off for ranching. So with that, let's now look at the hatch ranch design. Fortunately, this is the same for all four morphs, and follows the idea I explained in the main Critter Tutorial Bite. There is a stable room, incubators, and for the egg and critter overflow, we'll use a drowning chamber, or evolution chamber, to evolve the extra critters into meat. Starting with the first ranch design, it is relatively simple. Inside, we've got a grooming station and critter drop-off. The drop-off is set to 8 critters of the morph we want to ranch, and priority 9. All of the morphs can be fed with the critter feeder, so simply choose the desired food type here. Then an auto sweeper is here to load the critter feeder from an incoming conveyor receptacle. But you could also let Jupe supply it manually. As well as removing the extra eggs, the auto sweeper can remove the coal or a fine metal to a conveyor loader. The clever thing with this design is the door and tile inside. By putting this in, hatches cannot pass through as they can only climb up 2 tiles, keeping them near the grooming station. This means they can be groomed quicker, and the entire ranch can be swept by a single auto sweeper. As there is still a gap above, the room size is still counted, allowing us to make a 96 tile ranch with a 4x25 room. And to get to 96 tiles, we need to remove one more tile, which I like to do in the opposite corner, but you can do this anywhere. Each hatch requires 12 tiles of space, so a maximum sized ranch can have 8 hatches. Also know that you do need to use tiles in the area the hatches can walk, as they will bury into natural tiles during the day, making them impossible to groom. The other advantage of this design is that you can use the rest of the ranch for other things, such as industrial machinery, making it very space efficient. Just be careful not to put any buildings that would conflict the room type, and don't put any incubators here, as they would be counted towards the number of critters. But the hatch ranch is that simple, so let's look at dealing with the excess eggs and critters. Following the conveyor rail out of the hatch ranches, the eggs will be dropped into the evolution chamber, that we'll look at shortly. From here, they will be taken by Jupe to the incubators when there is space. Any eggs that hatch here will simply evolve into meat by themselves. The incubator setup is as I described in the critter tutorial bite. When these hatch, the ranches will be refilled if needed. Any extras are then taken to the evolution chamber too, with a priority 8 critter drop-off. As I mentioned in the critter tutorial bite, this overflow drop-off needs to be cleared regularly, so it doesn't get too full. Remember that a critter drop-off can only accept up to 20 critters in its room, so to speed up the evolving, we can use airlocks to flood the drop-off when needed. You can't simply keep the drop-off overly submerged, as it would count as flooded and not work. Firstly, we need to fill this room with water to just below the drop-off with the doors open. These airlocks are then automated, based on a critter sensor set to green if below 10 critters. Once this small room is too full, then the doors will start closing. To make sure that the water isn't deleted, they need to close in order to squeeze the water up. This is done with buffer gates set to increasing 2-second intervals. The water level then rises above the drop-off, and all the hatches are evolved inside. After they're all evolved, the sensor will reset, and the room is now free to accept more hatches. You can run the ranches as I've shown, but we can also add in some more solid shipping to automate things even more. Firstly, I've added a solid filter to take out the coal or metal to go elsewhere. And in the evolution chamber, a single auto sweeper and conveyor loader can collect the meat and eggshell produced. These are then filtered, and the meat is sent down to be used in an electric grill. Eggshells go left in this example, and can be sent to rock crushers to make lime for steel. I've also combined this with the conveyor loaders collecting eggshell from the incubators. At this point, I also wanted to include an alternative evolution chamber design. By building a small room and filling it with layers of different liquids, we can evolve critters immediately. Here I've used crude oil, petroleum and water that are bottle emptied in. There are a couple of kilograms per tile to not flood the drop-off. Again, there's an auto sweeper and loader to take away the meat and eggshells. If happy and fed, the hatch will lay an egg every 6 cycles. One full hatch ranch of 8 hatches then will produce on average 1 1/3 eggs per cycle. Hatching and evolving these will give a little over 4,000 kilocalories of meat, and turning this into barbecue gives a bit over 5,000 kilocalories per cycle. This means one ranch will sustain 5 dupes with barbecue. Finally then, here's a one-take reference for this ranch design. And that's everything I wanted to cover about ranching hatches. I hope this helps get you some delicious barbecue, and thanks for watching.